guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and today I'm excited to combine two worlds, okay? And what we're talking about is how to use Silhouette Studio when you are a Cricut user, okay? Now, I know you probably have a lot of questions about that. First of all, why would you want to do that? Well, because Silhouette Studio is a very robust software. Okay, there's a lot of things that you can do in Silhouette Studio, so even the free version, that you cannot do in Cricut Design Space. And then, of course, we are going to talk about different upgrades you may be interested in and how to move those designs from Silhouette Studio into Cricut Design Space so that you get the best of both worlds. You can create in Silhouette Studio and still cut on your Cricut. That way, especially if you're on the fence, there's no question on whether you have to upgrade your machine yet or not. Your Cricut will work just fine with a few of these hacks that we have. So let's go ahead and get started.
Okay, so the very first thing that you want to do is you want to come over here to silhouetteamerica.com/software. Okay, and the reason you want to come here is this is where you are going to download a version of the software. To download it, it is completely free. So I always recommend anybody on the fence about which machine to get, or if they're on the fence about switching to Silhouette, or even if you just need a designing software that has a not so steep learning curve, then come here and you can download the Silhouette Studio software for free. Now, this is the current version. You can see it says current version over here. Beta version is versions that are in testing, and legacy versions are older versions. And this is where I want you to go. And the reason that I say that is because a lot of times, and I'm not trying to be negative towards Silhouette Studio or any of their product developers, software designers, anything like that, but a lot of times the current version will have bugs. And that's only because there hasn't been as many bugs worked out. Okay, so that's all I'm gonna say about that. So I usually come down to the legacy version and I will choose, I believe this 4.3.370 is the one that I'm on. And you can do Mac or Windows. All right, so you will go ahead and download the software and you will go ahead and sign up for an account with Silhouette America. You do not have to pay anything. You do not have to buy anything, and it is not dependent upon the internet, okay? So that's also a big draw, and I know Cricut has caught up with that to some extent, but Silhouette America is really all there for being able to design without having internet access. So go ahead and download it, and then we will open it up, and I'm just going to go through a couple real quick things with you. And the main part of what we're going to focus on is getting your designs from Silhouette Studio into Cricut Design Space. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so when you come over into Silhouette Studio and you open it up, this is the main page that you're looking at. Okay, so it's set up. It usually defaults to a 12 by 12. You may or may not have a grid. You can turn that on and off. Your page setup menu is your very first icon up here. You can actually just go ahead and switch your machine to none if you're going to be transferring this over into Cricut Design Space. And then you can control your media size if you need to. 12 by 12 is fine for what you usually need to do. Okay, so let's talk about a few things that you can do in Silhouette Studio that you cannot do in Cricut Design Space. First and foremost, you can do an offset, and you also have access to font glyphs. Okay, so for example, if I type out my name, because I'm just like that, we will go over here. This is your text style panel, and you can select whichever font you want to use. So let's pick a fun one, Bohemia Spirit, okay? And of course you get this from Design Bundles, or rather fontbundles.net. But you can access the glyphs. Now let's pause, because you do need Designer Edition or higher of an upgrade. Designer Edition, you can usually buy it for under 30 bucks. Business Edition, which is the ultimate, you can usually find it for around 60 bucks. But the reason I go ahead and point this out is because for 30 bucks, you could do this, or 60 bucks, you could do this. And for me, it's totally worth it. Okay. And this is one thing that you cannot get to in any shape or form in Cricut Design Space. So moving along, this is your glyphs. You have this icon up here and you can scroll down and you can access all the really cool glyphs that go with the fonts that you purchase. Okay. So I will go ahead and I'm just going to erase my B. I will use a really fun B. And then I will do the same thing for my Y. Okay, so there we go. Now this is nothing special. I just wanted to show you how easy it is to use the glyphs. There's no character map to worry about. There's no font book to worry about, nothing like that, okay? Now what you want to do is you can right click and weld these together. That's not what I want to show you, but anytime you're using a script, you want to weld those together and then regroup them. We do have videos on using fonts and using glyphs in Silhouette Studio, so make sure you check those out after you make the transition. But what I'm wanting to show you is the ability to use an offset. Okay. Now, again, this you do not have this in Cricut Design Space. A lot of Cricut users will use Inkscape, and that's fine if that's what you want to do. But, you know, I think that Silhouette Studio is easier to use than Inkscape. Personal opinion. Probably because I already knew how to use Silhouette Studio. So, you know, I'm just going to cheat a little bit right there. But your offset is going to be the ability to create a border around whatever design. And, of course, you can control how thick or how thin of an offset you have. And this is really awesome. Anytime that you're creating layers with adhesive vinyl, or really heat transfer vinyl, too. Anytime you want to create print and cut stickers and you want to have that white border around your sticker, just a lot of really cool things that you can do with an offset. All right, so let's go ahead and color some of these in so you can actually see what I'm talking about. We will choose let's do orange. We'll do an orange font and we will just do a light orange offset. And I will change my line color to transparent because that's not really necessary. And now you can see that these perfectly line up. So I would be able to layer these with vinyl or, like I said, that could be my border if I'm doing something that's a print and cut or whatnot. So two really just really neat features, the ability to use glyphs and then also the ability to create an offset. You can also create your own rhinestone designs. You can actually create your own fonts with certain versions. You can create, if you like to do any type of etching or sketching with sketch pens, with the etching, I mean, you can etch on acrylic, you can etch on metal. Of course, those take special tools. So there's just a lot more features that you can get into with Silhouette Studio. So I'm going to stop bragging about Silhouette Studio, and I'm going to show you what you need to know. Now, the easiest way to transfer an image or a design from Silhouette Studio to Cricut Design Space is to upgrade to the Business Edition, which is what I have, and you can simply go to File, Save As, Save to Hard Drive, and I'll just throw this on my desktop. We will call it Becky, because that is my name, and here's where my dropdown, I would save it as an SVG file. Okay, now let's jump over to Cricut Design Space, and in Cricut Design Space, I can just go to Upload, and then I can find the image that I just created on my desktop, and there it is. Then I just click Save. It'll bring it into my canvas, insert images, and there it is. And everything looks just the way that it's supposed to look. Now, the only thing, the only hang up is that sizing does not stay the same. Okay. So what I would have to do is jump back over to Silhouette Studio and I would say, okay, this is sized to be 10.321. So then over here, I could type in 10.321. And then it would be the exact same size that it was in Silhouette Studio. That only matters if you've created something that you need to cut in an exact size. Okay, just know that when you save as an SVG from Silhouette Studio, you will have to resize it when you bring it into Cricut Design Space. All right, so let's talk about a couple different things that you can also do. Now, there is a website Now, on this website, now this is not, it's not associated with Sailor America. It says it's not approved by Sailor America. So other than using it, I don't know a whole lot about this website, but I do know that it works really well. So let's pause real quick. What am I talking about this website for? I'm talking about this website because if you are not ready to upgrade, all right, you don't want to drop $60 on Business Edition. What you can do is you can come here and you can choose file. You can find the studio version, which is basically just the it's the exact same thing, but it's a studio version and not an SVG. So I can locate that studio version, click open, go to convert studio to SVG. And what it's going to do is it's going to upload that studio file in here and it's going to convert it for you. And you see where it says download link. I will right click on here and I will choose save link as. And then now I can download it. Here, I'm going to go back to my desktop and download it and just choose save. Now it's going to download it and it's going to save it to my desktop. And then I can go back over to Cricut Design Space and open it up. So let's see what that looks like. So I go back to upload, upload image. Now I did title this Becky 2. That way we could tell the difference between the first and the second. And I'm going to choose save. And you notice it looks exactly the same. Let's look at sizing. So this sizing actually came in a lot closer. Remember we said that in Silhouette Studio it was size 10.321. Here is actually size 10.324. So really close sizing wise, and you know, all my colors stayed. The only thing that you can't do in bringing something over from Silhouette Studio, it doesn't matter which way you save it, whether you save it as a studio and convert it with that website, or if you save it straight as an SVG file from Silhouette Studio with Business Edition. Neither one of those supports the ability to be able to bring over shapes that are filled with a pattern. It will bring them over, but it will fill them in with black or a solid color. Okay, so let's talk about how to do that if you wanted to do something as a print and cut. All right, I will go ahead and delete these because we don't need those anymore. So back in Silhouette Studio, I will, you know what, I will leave that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to select that orange and I'm going to fill with a pattern. And I can choose any pattern I want. Okay, so I'm filled with a pattern. Let's come in here. And then say I still want that that white offset. Right? So I'm going to fill with white and I want to be able to print this as a print and cut sticker. Actually, that end of the arrow is looking a little funny. So make a compound path and fill with the pattern there. And I am also going to, I won't get too much farther into that. Okay. So I'm going to group those together and I'm just going to go to file, save as. And instead of saving as an SVG, I want to save this as a PNG. Now pause. Remember that I am doing this with Business Edition. You do have to have Business Edition to save as a PNG. Okay, but I'm going to show you a way around it too. All right, but this is the easy way. First, I'm showing you the easy way, and then I'm showing you the workaround. Okay, so I'm going to hit OK. I can. I always blow mine up. I do the biggest pixels. And I'm going to check for the transparent background. I'm going to hit save. And then over in Cricut Design Space, I can go to upload, upload images, find it on my computer. There we go. Now I can open that and choose open. And now you'll notice, if you can notice, that it gives me the transparent background because I saved it with a transparent background, but it keeps my pattern and this will be more obvious in a moment, but it gives me that white offset. Okay, so I can hit continue. Here we go. Here we get the blown up version. There we go. Let's zoom out a little bit. Now you can see my pattern and my offset. So I'll hit continue. And of course I can choose print then cut because that's what I want to do. The regular save as a cut image is kind of boring. Can't really decide what it says. And then I can just bring that into my canvas. And that is our, obviously it came over really big because I saved it really big. And what's our maximum? 9.25? If I go over to make it, there we go. I would be able to do a print and cut on my Cricut machine, even though I designed this in Silhouette Studio. Okay, now let's talk about the workaround. All right, what we can do is we're going to come over here, and from Silhouette Studio, I'm going to use the same exact design, and I'm going to save this as a PNG using a program called Bullzip. Okay, so it actually runs as a print driver. It actually runs as a print driver, so I'm going to hit print. And there it is, Bullzip PDF. I know it says PDF printer, but bear with me. We are going to change our preferences. Let's see. You know what? We don't have to do that. I'm making this complicated for you guys. I'm going to change the size of my media to show letter. Because see how that would have cut that off right there? I don't want that to happen. I'm going to rotate this around. And now with that on my letter size area, I can then go to File and Print. Find that Bullzip, and I can hit Print. What I was going to show you guys is in your print preferences, you can actually change the size of your print page setup. That way, if you wanted to create a design that was larger than a letter size paper, then you could, but you can't print and cut larger than letter size in Cricut Design Space anyway, so for this tutorial, it doesn't matter. But we're going to change the format to PNG, and let's see, we will name this not document. You know what, let's call this Becky 3. And it will open after creation. I don't really need to do that, but you can do it. It's good to have that when you're first starting out because you get the preview of it right away. So I can hit save. Now I'm going to jump back over to Cricut Design Space, go to upload. Now this won't be quite as easy as the original one, right? We agreed that this was a workaround, and I can choose, it doesn't matter, complex. Now, because I brought this over and it did not have a transparent background, then I am going to erase all of my white pieces. Now this isn't something that you guys should be surprised about. It's a little bit tedious for this design, so I will go ahead and just do a couple of them and then we'll skip ahead. But if you notice, I have also lost my offset. All right, so that's kind of a bummer, and I'd really have to focus to get in on all these. So if you're going, moral of the story, where I'm going with this, if you're going to use this method as your workaround, then you're going to want to try to stick to designs that don't have a lot of details for you to have to take out. All right, so we're going to stop there. I just wanted to show you how that works. But yes, I did lose my offset, and I can still do it as a print then cut, and I can set this up, but it's going to trim around the exact design instead of giving me kind of that sticker look that that sometimes I'm going for. So depends on the look you're going for. Now what you could have done is created a background that wasn't white. Okay, so we can look more into doing all that. Those are things that you can experiment with, but just know that the workaround is not flawless. So if you're doing a lot of print and cut stickers, you want to set them up in Silhouette Studio, but you want to cut them on your Cricut, that's fine, but you will probably want to upgrade for that. Okay, so I can bring this in and turn it, and it looks fine, but like I said, when you go to do your print and cuts, it's not going to cut the same. Okay, so we have gone over some really awesome methods to be able to design things in Silhouette Studio and bring them over into Cricut Design Space. A lot of people will ask me, do I think it's worth it? I absolutely do. If I had to choose between upgrading a $60 software or buying a whole new cutting machine, I would say, hey, keep your Cricut, use your Cricut. As long as there's nothing wrong with it and you like your Cricut, definitely just hang on to it. And then for $60, you can upgrade the software and you just get the best of both worlds, because I tell a lot of people I feel like on certain projects that my Cricut actually cuts better anyway. So I will still, even though I do have a Silhouette, I will still go ahead and design in Silhouette Studio and cut it on my Cricut. I get more reliable print and cuts that way. My Bluetooth works better. So there are benefits, obviously, to both cutting machines, but Silhouette Studio is hands down my favorite in terms of software, and now you can make it your favorite software as well.
So, I mean, I want to say it's straightforward. It's not. Hopefully you took some notes along the way. Or you know what? Just save this video. Save this video somewhere and you can come back and check in with me and ask any questions that you want, because I promise it is a lot easier than it seems. And I know it's a few extra steps, especially if you decide not to upgrade right away, right? But those steps are totally worth it. And I promise that once you really get the ins and outs of Silhouette Studio, you are absolutely going to be in love with the software, just like I am. So, all right, guys, if you have any questions, make sure you tuck those in the comments below. And make sure you subscribe to the channel, because we have a lot more fun tutorials planned for you right around the corner. Thanks, guys. We will see you next time.